In the last video about missing, though, I left off with a note mentioning how I would like to fix the sprites for all of the glitch Pokemon. In this video, I will do just that, to the best of my ability. Afterward, I'll show off a whole bunch of theoretical glitch Pokemon that don't and can't exist in the original game, but could be observed with some small hacks. Let's get into it. So in order to fix these glitched Pokemon sprites, we first have to identify what is wrong with them in the first place. It turns out there can be multiple interpretations of how these sprites can be fixed, so I'll run through a few. Remember, a Pokemon sprite is defined by a pointer to some compressed graphics data, and the size of a bounding box around the non-white space part of the graphic. And remember that the dimensions of this bounding box are defined in two separate locations, which are supposed to be identical, but can be different in the case of glitch Pokemon. The first error is that the pointer to the graphics data isn't actually pointing to graphics data, but to some unrelated location in the game's ROM. Unfortunately, there aren't any secret hidden graphics of unused Pokemon in the ROM, so these pointers really have nowhere to point to. These pointers are kind of what define the character of each glitch Pokemon. Some of them look like TV static, some are really stripey, and so on. I don't really want to mess with this, so we'll let this pointer stay the way it is for each glitch Pokemon. The second error is that the size of the bounding box is applied incorrectly when the width or height is 0 or exceeds 7. In the case of the dimensions that help the graphics data decompress in the first place, if the resulting bounding box encloses more than 49 total tiles, some of them are overwritten because the memory buffer that holds this data was only made large enough to hold this many tiles. In order to fix this, I will expand these buffers to be large enough to hold even the largest bounding boxes. At the decompression step, a width or height of 0 is interpreted as a width or height of 256 pixels, so I will even support this humorously large sprite if it comes up. In the case of the dimensions that help place blank tiles around the sprite, if the width or height was 0 or greater than 7, the algorithm would fail and a broken stair-step shaped sprite would be created instead. In order to fix this, I will use a different algorithm that creates the correct rectangle shape no matter how large the bounding box is. Again, a height of 0 is interpreted as 256 pixels, but a width of 0 in this step actually results in a sprite with a width of 256 tiles, or 2048 pixels. There's never actually enough graphics data to fill in this huge area, but I'll use this size anyway. The third error is that the two dimensions of the bounding box can be different in the two different steps just previously mentioned. Fixing this issue is more subjective than the other two. I could always pick the larger of the two bounding boxes, but this can create a sprite with a bunch of empty space in it if the amount of decompressed graphics is small. And I could always pick the smaller of the two bounding boxes, but this can leave out parts of a sprite if the amount of decompressed graphics is large. So I think I'll just show both options and let you decide which one looks better. I'm not going to walk through each and every glitch Pokemon, but I will talk about a few of the interesting ones. First off, Missingno, of course. When decompressing its graphics, the size of Missingno's sprite is defined to be 13 by 13 tiles. But since the original buffers only hold 7x7 sprites, or 49 tiles, some of the first buffer's data gets overwritten by the second buffer. First, let's expand these buffers so that all 169 tiles exist and don't get overwritten. This will end up changing Missingno's appearance quite a bit. Then, I'm actually going to switch the order of operations here and zipper the two bit planes together right now to form a four-color image instead of doing it at the end. Since this is all theoretical work, we aren't limited to the game's memory or anything, so we can afford to use memory space less efficiently. Besides, I think doing it this way makes more sense visually. Okay, so these are the 169 8x8 tiles that make up Missingno. Just for reference, here is what the original Missingno looks like, and all of the theoretical tiles it could have used. These highlighted tiles are the ones that actually show up in the sprite in-game. You can see that it doesn't use every single tile available. Most of them never get used, and some of them get overwritten with each other when the sprite gets crammed into the 7x7 tile box. But I'm going to go ahead and fix this sprite by making it actually 13x13 tiles, which looks like this. This sprite uses all of the available graphics data exactly once, so I would consider this to be the purest form of Missingno's visual form. And then for good measure, this is what Missingno would look like if it were 8x8 tiles, which is the size of its original bounding box. Both of these sprites can be considered correct though, since most glitch Pokémon have two defined dimensions. Here's one of my favorite sprites, glitch Pokémon with Pokédex number 234, those with IDs 194, 200, 211, 217, and 234. This is what this one looks like in the original game, but here is what it would look like if it could take up its full size of 6x10 tiles. Its bounding box is only 6x1 though, so if you apply the bounding box to the sprite, you only see this little sliver of it. Again, the sprite looks a little different, and this is because the two halves of the sprite never clash with one another during the decompression process. If you want to learn more about that, there will be another follow-up video released soon after this one that will go into much more detail on this algorithm. Let's look at one more in depth. This is the glitch Pokémon with Pokédex number 255, which has the internal ID of 245. In the previous video, I showed this Pokémon looking like this instead. This Pokémon has a bounding box size of 0x0, and its graphical dimension is 5x0. In the original game, trying to display the front sprite of this Pokémon crashes the game, so in order to get this image, I disabled part of the algorithm so it wouldn't crash. But in doing this, it made the final result not as accurate. Simulating the same algorithm with the same buffer size, but with an expanded overall memory size, generates this sprite on the left instead, since, again, the two halves of the sprite clash with each other and one completely erases the other. That's why the sprite only has two colors instead of four, since one of the bit planes became completely empty. Now, let's look at what this sprite would look like without any memory buffer overlapping. The graphical dimension of this glitch Pokémon is 5x0 tiles, but like mentioned before, a width of 0 is treated as a width of 256 pixels, or 32 tiles. So the pure form of Pokémon number 255 looks like this. And if you want to apply the bounding box, this is where it gets real fun. The bounding box is defined to be 0x0 tiles, but this is actually treated as 256 tiles by 256 pixels, or 32 by 256. This massive area gets filled with the same tiles as before in column order like usual. Of course, only 5 columns get filled before we run out of graphics, but technically this is the entire sprite. I'll let the rest of the glitch Pokémon scroll by on your screen right now so you can take a look at them all. I'm not showing the non-glitch Pokémon since they only have one pure intended form. Nothing ever malfunctions in the sprite drawing algorithm, so there's nothing really of interest there. Just like before, any highlighted in red are sprites with graphics data pulled from anywhere but ROM, so these have the potential to look different each time they are loaded. In fact, since the dimension byte used for decompression is bundled with the sprite data, it also has the ability to be different each time the sprite is loaded, which means the true size of the sprite isn't the same every time. I've highlighted these dimension values in red as well. For generating the sprites in this list, I used a snapshot of memory from a point in the game when you are checking a Pokémon's stats in its status screen, and the decompression buffer and Hall of Fame data is completely empty. Many of these glitch Pokémon share the same Pokédex number, so they will end up sharing the same sprite graphics. They will end up sharing the same sprite dimensions for decompression, but not necessarily the same for the blank area around the sprite, which means the same tiles could be arranged in a different order. Now, what if I told you there were even more glitch Pokémon than these? You can't really encounter them in the game without super intensive glitches or arbitrary code execution, but they had the potential to show up just by chance, just like all of these sprites here. A Pokémon's ID is a single byte which can range from 0 to 255. Normally this ranges from 1 to 190, Anything higher than 190 belongs to glitch Pokemon. Zero also wasn't normally used, as well as various other IDs within this range that belong to Missingno. But each Pokemon also has their Pokédex number, which is also a single byte ranging from 0 to 255. The intended range for these values was 1 to 151, but some glitch Pokemon use 0 or go above 151. However, some Pokédex numbers outside of the range are just never used. For example, Pokédex number 152 is never used, not even by a glitch Pokemon. But we can hack in Pokemon that has this Pokédex number and see what it looks like. This glitch Pokemon doesn't have an ID number, so it doesn't even have a name. But, since it has a Pokédex number, it has everything that is determined by a Pokemon's Dex number. This includes things like base stats, types, catch rate, initial moveset, and front and back sprites. Here is a list of all of the glitch Pokemon you'd get if you could set the Pokédex number to anything you want. There's nothing particularly interesting out here, but it is cool to know that the glitch Pokemon that exist in the game are just a small sample of the out-of-bounds entries of this table. There is a link in the description to a zip file that contains all of the sprites you see here, as well as the ones earlier in the video if you want to see them all at once. Unlike the group of glitch Pokemon showed earlier, these are almost all unique, since it is very unlikely, though not impossible, for the pointer to the sprite's graphics data to be a repeat of another. All of these glitch Pokemon have unique Pokédex numbers after all. You can really tell, especially with the much larger sprites, that long horizontal stripes and scratchy vertical strips seems to be a theme here. Again, this is just due to how exactly the sprite data is decompressed and decoded, which I will go more in depth about in the next video. That's all for me for this video though. Please enjoy the rest of the hidden glitch Pokemon scrolling down your screen for the rest of the video. Thanks for watching,